On this episode of the Grand Circle Tour podcast.
Ewan McGregor's dad called him and said, "Hey, I heard you're coming back home for a few months to film your series." And he goes, "Dad, don't believe every rumor you hear."
Well, probably looking not. Forward to the possibility of Ratatouille being open on our trip.
He was like, "Wait, what? A 14-hour wait for a cookie?" I'm like, "Yeah, but they look really good."
Hello, passengers. So yes, you have a regularly scheduled episode right after this, but it is 10:30 in the morning on Wednesday, February 17th, and the Cruella trailer has just dropped. George and I are here to talk about it really quick with you guys. Once this is done, your regularly scheduled episode will be right after us. George, Cruella, tell me about it. What'd you think?
Well, first, it was plastered all over social media. It was on Facebook. It was on Instagram. It was on Twitter. I mean, this trailer just kind of blew up last minute without no one expecting anything. And when I saw the still photos, when they first showed like the original concept images of Emma Stone as Cruella, I thought this is going to be, and part of my French, a one kick-ass movie.
Yeah.
It's by the still photos. It looked great. And I couldn't wait for the first trailer to drop whenever it was going to, and today is the day, and I will say it did not disappoint.
Not at all. Disney had me when they said three words: Emma Stone, 1970s, and punk rock, and I was all in. And I'm not going to lie, the trailer is 90 seconds. I think I've watched it 30 times this morning.
I watched it multiple times as well.
Yeah.
And I think you and I can both agree that just going by off the trailer, that it kind of dips down into the psychological turmoil of the character, sort of how Batman's Joker was.
You know, that's the feeling I got. This was like the Disney version of the Joker.
Yeah. And I like the different style to it. It's completely different than what Disney is so used to doing. And I like how they're kind of stepping away from just that typical, you know, remake origin of the classic story, and
which I have enjoyed a bunch of the live action remakes, but this is, I don't know, something about this speaks to me. This is like Disney decided, hey, Skipper Jay's been a good boy, let's make a movie just for him.
It would definitely seem that way, because it's completely different than what they're used to making, and I like how they're kind of stepping away from their traditional filmmaking.
I really hope this is on Disney Plus, because I don't want to go to a theater, but we will be reviewing this as soon as it's available on May 28th. Yes. So should we watch the trailer and commentary?
Let's do it.
Let's do it. I love Emma Stone. She can do no wrong.
No, she can't. And I love how in the beginning of how it started that Cruella doesn't look like her typical self.
No.
This
definitely feels like a Batman origin story.
It really does, especially when she's walking with the alcohol, and it's...
Yeah.
And I'm assuming the other
that,
woman...
That laugh, I just have to say, she mastered that laugh. Holy cow.
She did. She really did. And I love how it has like this Victoria... And then, of course, with the dogs.
Yeah.
They had to throw in the Dalmatian. So I'm assuming, is that her mother?
I figured it was her boss and kind of, what was that movie with Meryl Streep?
Oh, the Devil
Wears Prada, yeah. There she is hot wiring a car. Okay, this could be straight out of a Batman trailer.
This kind of reminded me the style, like with her mascara and everything.
Yeah.
It kind of has like that graphic novel sort of.
And I gotta say, Emma Stone is so pretty. I love the fact that she's not afraid to get ugly for this role.
Yes.
I want to go to this party. I guess that's what happened to her house in the animated feature.
Yeah, I guess so.
I'm Cruella.
And then what a perfect way to end that trailer.
Dude, seriously, I'm so excited for this movie. Holy cow.
I cannot wait for this.
May 28th. I can't wait to do the review. I can already tell. I think this is my favorite Disney movie of 2021.
I think it's going to do really well. And I think, honestly, if, you know, Disney does this right, I would say if they want to still release it in theaters, that's fine. But also, I think with this kind of movie, people would pay for the early premiere access on Disney.
I will gladly pay the $29.99 to watch this at home.
So I really think people would get their money's worth if they were to do this right.
Right. So let's not keep everyone from their regularly scheduled podcast. Thanks, everyone. We had to bust in and tell you how cool we thought this trailer was. All right, everyone. Now on with the show.
The Disneyland Limited, now leaving for a grand circle tour of the Magic Kingdom. All passengers board.
Star Tours announces the boarding of the Endor Express. All passengers, please prepare for immediate boarding.
Please stand clear of the doors. Por favor, manténganse alejado de las puertas. To those guests who've just joined us, welcome. For those of you standing, please hold on to the handrails throughout our journey and stay clear of the doors.
Please keep your hands, arms, and legs inside the train and remain seated at all times. Now, hang on to them hats and glasses, because this here's the wildest ride in the wilderness.
I am Sam, the American Eagle, and I am proud to introduce the Grand Circle Tour Podcast, a celebration of Disney parks, but mostly the American ones. I really like these guys.
Hey, gang, welcome to another exciting adventure of the Grand Circle Tour Podcast. I am your host, Dan Solo, and I'm here with my three favorite co-hosts. Count them, three. I'm going to start off, ladies first, alphabetical. We're going to start off with Ringmaster Holly. I had to go to the alphabet there for a second. I was just joking. Holly, how are you today? And Walt's up.
I'm doing really great. Thank you. I have actually quite a few Walt's up, but I'll just go with one of them since the other one we're going to discuss anyhow. But I had a really great mail delivery today, UPS actually. So we had him on our show a while back, Derek from Satisfactual Signs. Mm-hmm. I had ordered a couple of his signs and I received them today. So that's always fun getting mail like that. And I was so happy with the quality of these. I know we were, you know, we've seen them on the pictures and on the live that we did, but man, they were so great in person. So I'm really happy with them. Even better than I expected.
Well, I really want one of these.
Yeah.
Did he not work for Disney making signs before?
Yeah. I can't remember. He was at Disney finishing something. I don't know. So yeah, he did some aspect of it, but he didn't make them.
When he was on the live show, he said that he had worked for Disney, and so that's why he knew a lot more about what materials they use to make their signs so they would stand up to the elements, and so he was able to kind of use some of those same elements.
Yeah, so they're made out of resin, and I mean, I wasn't expecting the paint job to be that great on them. Honestly, I don't know why. Because it's just one guy, he's, you know, doing it. Well, I think it's full-time work now for him, but the painting on it was really great. So I was really impressed. I'm really happy with them. I got a Jungle Cruise sign and Mickey and Minnie gingerbread. So he said that I was lucky because those were like the last set of the gingerbread for this year. Well, probably until, you know, closer to Christmas again. So they're really cute. They have, a little place to like a sign holder on the back, a little hook. So really impressed. But and he sells out within 5 minutes or so because he had a sale again today while we were driving here. So yeah.
I know I was rushing home and I missed it.
Oh yeah. He had a lot of items today. So what he does is he like puts them up for sale, what he thinks he can make in the next 3 weeks. And then he, you know, like basically you're pre-ordering. So he had a lot of new stuff out today, the snacks. He's doing a donut, a waffle, an ice cream bar. They're really cool.
So tune in about a month from now and you'll be able to.
Yeah.
maybe buy something from him if you missed out this go round.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, his work is amazing. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Also joining us today is the food fairy, Kris Banas. Kris, how are you today and Walt's up?
I'm good. My Walt's up, I actually have a couple like Holly, but, and I don't want to do them because it's going to It's going to give away what we're going to talk about. But the other one is I started reading a new Star Wars book a couple weeks ago, and I kind of put it down and kind of forgot where I put it. So I started reading again, and it's the story of Obi-Wan. So I think it's kind of like a lead into the movie or series that's going to be coming out.
Okay.
So it's going to be interesting to see how the book transitions into this, or what from the book is going to be in that. But the next one that I'm going to start reading after I'm done is the Ahsoka book.
Oh, cool. Is that going to lead into her show? That's too early to decide.
Yeah, I think that's too early. So we'll see.
Start filming Obi-Wan this summer, and they're going to be filming in LA, surprisingly.
Mm-hmm.
Every rumor in the world was saying it's going to be in UK.
Yeah.
Ooh, maybe my kids can be in it.
Yeah, maybe. That'd be cool. Because I heard a good story. Ewan McGregor's dad called him and said, "Hey, I heard you're coming back home for a few months to film your series." And he goes, "Dad, don't believe every rumor you hear." He says, "We're filming in LA." He was doing an interview and told this story. Also joining us is the mission commander, Justin Clark. How are you today? And Walt's up.
I am doing fantastic. Boy, Walt's up. Obviously I've been watching a lot of WandaVision for our roundtable discussions. We also just rewatched Hunchback of Notre Dame because we hadn't watched that in a long time.
Mm.
And that was kind of an interesting rewatch.
Yeah, I love that movie. And
see how that movie holds up.
Yeah, I haven't watched that in forever. I haven't watched it since I had it on a VHS when it first came out. I think it was like the last time. Probably the only time I ever watched it. Yeah. Oh, that's so cool. I got to get back into watching some old Disney movies. Got to find some time. I've been spending less time on Facebook, so that might help.
Yeah.
It does help. Yeah.
Yeah. With myself, you know what? I'm going to plug our sponsor. We got a new sponsor for the show, in case you haven't heard. Dream Creators Travel, and in particular, Jennifer G and Julissa. Julissa. Yes, sorry. Good thing I practiced the names. Yeah, Julissa and Jennifer G from Dream Creators Travel. You could find them at dreamcreatorstravel.com. But this is the thing. If you book this month, you're probably sitting on the fence deciding whether to book or not. You book with them this month, in February, you get a $25 gift card simply by letting them know that you heard about them from us, the Grand Circle Tour podcast. And in our Facebook page, we have the announcements at the top of the Facebook page. Mm-hmm. You go there, click the announcements, you'll see where the link is. You click the link, you fill out the form, they contact you, you book your vacation. When you get to your vacation destination, whether it's Universal Studios, Disney World, Disney Cruise Line, once they start going, Disneyland, once it opens, SeaWorld, anywhere you want to go, they can book it for you. No fee. They get paid by the places that are hiring them to get you there. So you don't have to pay them anything extra. In fact, chances are you're going to save money. And it's a win-win situation for sure. You're helping us out. You're helping them out, which are, they're two great people. So check it out. Dream Creator.
It's funny because, sorry, I mean, I cut you off there,
but go ahead.
The last couple of days I've had a couple people reach out to me asking, where do they start with planning to go to Walt Disney World? Because everyone's over it now, having Disneyland closed for so long. So they're finally like, okay, we need some Disney. And it really is a lot. If you have never been, and I'm like, you really need to just get a travel agent because they don't cost you anything. And they're going to be really helpful, especially there's long wait times right now to buy tickets, to make changes, to book things. And they either have shortcuts or they're going to wait on hold for you. So that's another reason, even just to get ideas from them of how to start. And they can help you, give them a budget and they can help you, you know, within reason. You can't say, but I want to go for $500, but you know, and they know all the specials. And one of their things too, is they're going to help you if a special comes out before you go on your trip, they'll help you get that special too. So it's a really good idea. So yeah, definitely reach out to them, especially who doesn't want an additional $25 gift card to, you know, get those snacks. So
Yeah, no kidding. And that kind of ties into what we're going to be talking about today. We're going to be planning a trip for the three of you are coming up on a trip soon.
Yeah.
And we're going to be, so if this is your first time going to Disney World or this is your 150th time going to Disney World, it's always fun to kind of plan out where you're going to eat, where you're going to stay, stuff like that. And so maybe this will help you plan your trip just by hearing what my three co-hosts are doing for their upcoming trip. And I'm not jealous one bit. Not.
I know this is like salt, right? In your wound, like making you host this.
Hey,
like,
Stan, this we got a good idea. You host our trip report before we go.
And I know. Stan, especially since all three of us are going to be there at the exact same time.
I know.
Which is like, what? Well,
no, not exactly.
Well,
I think I'm there before you are.
But we're still going to be there during part of our trip at the same
time. We're going to be at the airport at the same time.
Yeah.
He's leaving. I'm coming in.
Yeah.
And you know what? I got some news today. I was listening to the radio, and I guess because travel is so much down right now in Canada, it's like, what do they say, 98% or 97% less air flights in and out of Canada than it was a year ago.
Mm-hmm.
So they laid off thousands and thousands of people that work in the airline industry. And now they're getting new jobs. Like, they're moving on with their lives. They're finding other places to work. So once they start flying again within Canada and outside of Canada, it's going to be a long time before things get up and running, because they only have to rehire baggage hire everybody, you know, mechanics and all this stuff. They're saying it could take up to 4 years before it gets back to normal for Canada.
Wow.
Oh my goodness. So
what they're predicting is that airfares are going to be extremely expensive once we start flying again, because the supply will not meet the demand at all, because there won't be nearly enough people to manage the amount of people that want to fly.
So you're going to have to drive to the US, right, and then catch a flight. Is that an option?
That's what a lot of people do. I know, like especially in the Toronto area, they've been doing that anyways, going to Buffalo or whatever. It's not that easy for me to do that, but I do know people in my city that do that. They go to Grand Forks and fly out of Grand Forks.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's a long day.
Like 4 or 5 hours for you, wouldn't it?
Yeah. It's like a 4 or 5 hour drive, and then a flight to either Minneapolis or Chicago, and then from Chicago to Minneapolis to...
Oof.
And then coming back would be the same thing, and you're paying for your car to be, you know, there, and it's just gonna be a mess.
Yeah.
Anyways, I'll see you guys in 5 years when I go. But in the meantime, I'll live through you all.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, so let's get this show on the road. Kris, we'll start. Or sorry, Holly, we'll start off with you. So when are you going?
We are going in 12 days.
Okay, can you give us dates? Because by the time this comes out, you're going to be there already.
I'm going February 27th to March 5th.
Okay, so Holly is February 27th to March 5th. I'm going to write this down, not that it matters to anybody. And Kris, when are you going?
Mine is March 1st to March 6th.
Okay, so now here we're going to find out who, to March 6th?
Mm-hmm.
You got a bit of a shorter one.
Yeah.
Yeah. And Justin.
No, mine's, remember, it's February, so it's not that. Mine sounds long, but it's not.
Yes, I guess it's only one extra day. Yeah.
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 Okay. I know, like, I went to Disney World one time. I went for the entire month of February.
Oh my gosh.
Wow. Like,
I went for a week to Disney World, and I did a 7-night cruise, and then I did a week at Disney World.
Yeah. Solo. That's awesome.
That was great. But it was like nearly the entire month of February, because it was just a short month. Justin, when are you going?
Okay, so I'm going to be there from February 22nd through the 28th. So I'll be gone.
Okay.
So that's what I was saying. I think I'm gone just before she gets there.
Yeah, you'll be. Yeah, so you'll be, Holly gets in the 27th, you're leaving.
He gets in the day before you leave.
Right. Right.
And Kris wouldn't have been there yet. Okay, so now that answers that argument. All right, we're all on the same page.
And actually, one of our passengers is going to be there at the same time as well.
Well, I'm thinking there's going to be a couple of hundred of our passengers that are going to be there at the same time.
Well, that we know of, because he's already contacted Holly and I about meeting up. So we know he's going to be there when we're there. So
Oh yeah, yeah, good friend. Of, yeah, well, he's been on the show. Yeah. Scott Clark will be there.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. For his birthday as well.
Yep.
Yeah, Scott and I were supposed to go on a couple trips together last year, and that okay, Holly, where you staying?
This time we are staying at the Old Key West.
And where did you stay last time? Wasn't it?
Saratoga Springs, right next door. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So I'm a little bit more excited about staying here because we haven't stayed here before. And last time it was a nightmare at Saratoga Springs. So we're hoping that it's going to be better at this resort. And I think all of these rooms are renovated here. So.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Because you did not get a renovated room last time. And by the way, if you want to hear about Holly's trip and Chris's trip, go to the solo show. We did a pre-post trip report for both of them.
Yeah.
So, and because they went not to, when you just went like what last week, didn't you, Holly?
Pretty much. We just went last month. So.
Okay. And you're going with your family, so it's gonna be
yes.
How many? Like you got a family of 80, I think, don't you?
Or yeah, exactly. So yeah, it's because we went last month, just my husband and I, and then we got back and flights were still super cheap. And the resort came up and I'm like, okay, let's just take the kids. It's Simon's birthday. He'll be turning 11. So it just works out. I mean, I usually spend a fortune doing birthday parties anyways. So this, now I don't have to do a birthday party.
Can't which have is a party usually, though, anyway, either.
Yeah,
so. Exactly.
You don't have to worry about it.
It's usually a lot of work. So we're going to be there for his birthday. And so it's going to be the six of us.
Okay. And that's why we call you Ringmaster, because you got.
Exactly. I have a circus.
Wherever you go. Okay. And Chris, you're just doing you and your husband. You're doing a solo trip.
I'm going by myself again. Yeah.
Cool. Okay. So we got the family and we got the solo trip.
Yeah.
And where are you staying?
I am staying at Art of Animation again.
Nice.
Little Mermaid section, because it's just me. Mm-hmm. But I love it there. And because, you know, Little Mermaid, she's my BFF. So I like staying over there in that section. And you know what? It's so with Skyliner access now for that resort, it's so convenient. So that's another motivation for me to stay there.
And you went recently. You went like this
was
year.
There in December. Yep.
Oh, December.
Beginning of December. Yeah. It was actually November 28th to December 8th. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So a few months ago.
Mm-hmm.
All righty. Now, Justin, you're going on a couples trip.
Yes, it's just me and my wife. No kids, just the two of us. Mm-hmm. We haven't, and I'll say, unlike these other two, we haven't been there for a while. We have not been to any Disney park since January of 2018.
Wow.
So it's been a while. We are in some serious withdrawal.
Mm-hmm. I am very envious of where he is staying.
Yes. Yeah, so tell us where you're staying.
Oh, well, it's just this little place off to the side. It's called Grand Floridian, I think. Right off to the side of Magic Kingdom.
Oh, that is so awesome. If you haven't been in a long time, it's good to, you know, let's go for the big one already.
Well, and that was really our justification for it. To splurge because we hadn't gone for such a long time. And we actually got a pretty good deal through the Disney Visa credit card. Mm-hmm. Was it an even better deal than what you could get on the regular sales at the time? So we were like, what the hey, let's go for it.
Yeah, I don't blame you. I would too, especially just the two of you. That's awesome.
I will tell you though, speaking of Scott Clark, him and I were at Magic Kingdom one time and I was staying at Pop Century and he was at the Grand Floridian. And we left together, it was Scott and his wife, and I got back to, and I said, man, you're going to be in bed before I get back to Pop Century. And he goes, yeah, it's so nice to be close. I mean, it's different now. They got the bridge. But I got back to Pop and I messaged him and I said, yeah, I'm back at the room finally, taking the bus. And he said, we're still not at a resort. I guess the monorail line was so long that they got tired of waiting that they turned around and left, and then they got into the line for the boat, and I'm not sure if he was in the wrong line or or something. It was a mix-up, but yeah, I got back to Pop Century by bus faster than it took him to get to Grand Floridian. But I mean, now you can
Now you can just walk, and it's a really nice walk. It's not that long. It's very
like
pleasant.
10 minutes or
did
something.
It myself, and it was really nice. So,
so Justin, are you going to take advantage of where you're staying and visit Magic Kingdom a few times, or what are your plans there?
We might go to Magic Kingdom at least one day. You know.
Well, you have your reservations already. Do you not? Or
yeah, we have the reservations for all the parks.
You need a travel agent if you haven't got this done.
Right. I'm like, uh-oh.
It's been a while, I know, but
I started to panic for him a little bit.
You don't just show up anymore. So you're going to Magic Kingdom once, twice?
We'll be at Magic Kingdom 2 days. We've got 2 days scheduled for Hollywood Studios, partly because I haven't seen Galaxy's Edge yet.
Right.
We have 1 day at Animal Kingdom, and our first day is actually going to be at Epcot. When we get off the plane, we're going straight there because that is the last day of a Festival of the Arts.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to try to catch the tail end of that before that's done.
Oh, cool. You have to see if you have any Craig Skaggs paintings left.
He would be at Acme Archives, which I believe is in the Italy Pavilion.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
according to what I looked up already.
Cool. Now, are you going to be, when you're at Grand Floridian, you're going to be looking for like old NBA stuff left behind? Like maybe they lost one of their rings or something like that.
I was hoping maybe they'd thrown one of their trophies off to the side and I could just pick it up. You know,
look under the bed, see if there's a basketball left there or something.
Yeah.
Nobody noticed it yet. So Holly, you just went recently. Is there anything that new that you want to try other than food that you, I mean, it's hopefully the people movers moving. Yeah, hopefully the people movers moving by
then. I've given up on that, but George did post that they were testing it. There was people actually writing it today, and I'm like, I'm not even gonna, if it's open, I'm not even gonna wish for it. So
if it happens,
they're still saying March 1st before they'll open it.
Okay, so
right after we're gone,
so that would work for me because we'll be there on the 4th. So but if it is because I just can't get my hopes up anymore.
I'm all feeling sad for Justin because he's never seen Galaxy's Edge. Holly's never ridden the people mover. At least Justin's done that.
We basically did everything last time. Like everything except what was that? The merry-go-round.
Carousel.
Carousel. Prince Charming. Yes,
I think that was the only thing that we didn't do.
Yes,
that I can think of. Oh, and the something de France. What was that? The show
Impressions de France.
Yes, so we didn't do that. We were tired because we were going to have to walk all the way back to the other side because it's only showing in the evening. And so, but other than that, we did everything last time. So.
Do any of the rest stops? I know that you said you didn't visit any of the rest areas.
I don't like to rest. I just like to go.
You would have went to the Impressions de France. You would have had a nap. how about
that's
you, Chris?
What the American Adventure is for? I'm sure.
I did take a nap in there. Oh, I feel so bad because it was a really good show, but I did actually
nod off. I don't think I've ever not nodded off.
Yeah, it was so good, but
then toward the end, they have all that gunfire, and you're waking up going, "Please, I'm trying to sleep here.
What's happening?"
There was a mom and her son. He could not wake up. She and they had to move so we could all get out of the line. And he was a bigger kid, and she's trying to lift him and wake him up, and she could not get him. She was like dragging him out, and you're just like,
oh my gosh.
I felt so bad for her, but it was so funny.
Put some water bottle on that.
Oh man,
it is a good show, but by that point, you've walked so much.
Yeah.
and you're sitting down in air conditioning for the first time and who knows how long by that
or heating in my case it was heat. Yeah. So yeah, I was cozy. Uh-huh.
Yeah, you froze last time.
Yeah.
You need to go back just to warm up. This go round. How about you, Kris? Is there anything new, not counting food?
Well,
probably looking not.
Forward to the possibility of Ratatouille being mm-hmm. open on yeah. our trip. I know Holly is looking forward to that as well. There are inklings that it could very well be open when we are there. So I'm keeping every finger and every toe crossed. It's going to be really hard for me to walk 75 miles like I did on my last trip with my toes crossed. But I'm going to try. So,
you've been often enough. Now, Justin, okay, so what do you got? You got the People Mover, you got Mickey Minnie's Runaway Railroad, you got Smuggler's Run, you got Rise of Resistance.
I haven't seen anything in Galaxy's Edge yet. Haven't been on the Skyliner. Haven't seen the new Toy Story Land. Haven't seen the new.
Oh my goodness. You how exciting. New Toy Story Land?
No, you haven't I haven't seen the new Toy Story Land.
Oh my gosh.
You're
oh,
going to wow. be blown away.
Yeah.
This is awesome. This is absolutely
great. Last time was my first time seeing it too, and I was impressed.
It's very cool.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I have seen Toy Story Land in Hong Kong Disneyland. So I have seen a Toy Story Land, but I haven't seen the one here in Florida yet.
Mm-hmm. Plus they got the new Pixar area too, then that you obviously haven't seen that mm-hmm. used to be where Toy Story Midway Mania entrance was. Cause now you come in through the back of Midway Mania.
Yeah.
So that'll be a new little area too. I'm guessing are they still doing that Cars attraction?
They are. Matter of fact, there was just a post on the Disney cast member thing on Facebook day before yesterday about it. So
that would be new for you also then, for sure. You haven't even heard about it. It's in Hollywood Studios.
Okay, so I take it back. We didn't do that last time either because I don't know.
You got to take Simon to that. Simon
So now we'll do that. And then we have to do the Disney Junior thing too because the twins love that. So we didn't do that because, I mean... You know, but we'll do that this time.
do that with the kids. The kids will like it.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can have a little, but it's hard to nap because your benches, there's no seat.
Right.
You have to rest against each other's shoulders or something. It's kind of loud too. It's cute. It's cute. It's fun. It's very, Justin, I think will like it. It's very high tech.
I like high tech.
Yeah, you like high tech. Just the technology involved to it was the exciting part. Okay, so let's talk food. We've been going 26 minutes. We haven't talked food yet.
Yeah,
what? Anyways.
So, Holly, new restaurants you haven't tried?
Yeah, so last time we just had just the best food. And we tried so many restaurants. But there was...
Try to find some crap.
Yeah, so this time we want cheap crap. Fast, right? No. So
chicken nuggets for everybody.
Pretty much. It's going to be on the agenda. Yeah.
It sounds like justice type of food.
Yeah. Cosmic rays. No. So I actually got reservations for sci-fi. So I think that will be cool for the family to go.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how great the food is. I think it's just burgers or whatever, but I think it's something cool. And then... Via Napoli. So we had reservations last time, but I canceled them. Right. But we're going to Epcot on Simon's birthday. So we're definitely going to have to do fish and chips. We'll probably do that for lunch because he loves fish and chips. But then I figured that would be a good place for the family to eat, you know, get one of those huge pizzas. Mm-hmm. And then.
Okay. Via Napoli. Yeah. Never mind. I'm sorry. I'm thinking.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
And then Magic Kingdom, we enjoyed Be Our Guest so much that I wanted to take the family back this time. So I think I have to take a loan out on my house to afford it to pay for all of us. But I know when I told Kris that, my husband Kris said, I made us reservations at Be Our Guest. He was just silent because he already knows how much our bill was, just the two of us, but adding. And especially because I think it's under 10. 3 to 9 is a child and I'm going to have 2 over that. So I really only have two children, so it's going to be four adults. So I don't know. Yeah. But I'm hoping still to get
a pre-fix menu type of thing. Like
It is.
We'll keep the rest of the day.
Exactly. So I'm hoping to still try to get a later reservation like we did last time, closer to the park closing right now. I thought I was good, but then good and bad, they just increased the hours again. They added an additional hour. So now my reservation is not before park closing. So I keep checking, and I have someone also has an alert, or the mouse dining. I have an alert. So hopefully I can get something a little bit later. So my kids can see the empty Main Street too.
Yeah. Those are so cool. How about you, Kris?
I've actually got some plans of quite a few places that I've never been on this trip. Going to my day of arrival, going to Disney Springs, and I have a reservation at the City Works and Brewing Company. I've heard some really good things about it, and I'm going there with a couple friends. I am going the next day. I'm going to Crystal Palace. Now, of course, I've been there many times. However, it's completely different with no buffet. So I really want to see what is going on there as far as meals go.
That'd be really interesting as a solo traveler, because it's family style dining. How much do they bring you?
They just bring you enough for one person, and if you want more, they bring it. So it's nice.
That'd be interesting. I'm ready to hear the report on that.
Yeah, I ran into that at Liberty Tree Tavern on my last trip, so it worked out. Mm-hmm. Holly and I have a reservation on my birthday at Oga's Cantina for a cocktail to celebrate my birthday. So we're going to be drinking before noon. So this is
I know. Poor Kris. He's never going to find me again.
We're all good.
And then I'm actually going to not that I haven't been here before, but never on my birthday. I have a reservation at the Boathouse for 7 o'clock that night. I'm going to, on March 4th, I'm going to San Angel Inn for the very first time. I always wanted to eat there because it looks so pretty in there, but I've never had a reservation to eat there before. So that's going to be fun.
For people who don't know, that's the one in the Mexican Pavilion that's inside the pavilion the boats go by. Yeah. That's a really cool dinner.
Yeah. Like it's very pretty. So I'm anxious to, and you know, I've heard some good and bad things about the food. So hopefully they'll have a good day when I'm there. I'm also going to the Wave at the Contemporary for the very first time. And I've heard some really good things about that. And then my day of departure, I was not going to have a park day that day. I was originally going to go to Disney Springs, but after I renewed my annual pass, I'm like, what am I limiting myself for? Right. So I'm going to go to Magic Kingdom the day that I leave, because my flight doesn't leave till 5:40. So I have a good, you know, like half a day that I can go.
Yeah.
And I'm going to go to Tony's Town Square for the very first time. So yeah.
Hopefully it isn't burnt down by then.
I know. Don't tell Mary.
Oh, that's cool. I'm curious to hear about that one as well, because I heard it.
Yeah, me too.
And it's much better. Mm-hmm. So it's funny, big. Like I've never been to Tony's, and I've been to Crystal Palace a few times. I'm really interested to hear how all those are. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So Justin, you spent all your money at the Grand Floridian. So
they're going to be eating cheeseburger spring rolls every day.
Well, those are expensive too.
So listeners should probably, they've heard me before say that my plans are generally whatever's the closest place to eat, especially if it has mobile ordering. But we do have some reservations this time.
Oh, good. Yeah, we're all shocked.
Yes, we're all shocked. Our mouths are hanging open with anticipation. Go, go, go.
Okay, so we have a character breakfast set up at Topolino's the one morning.
Ooh, oh my gosh, you're going to love it. So good.
We have a reservation for the Edison over at Disney Springs.
You'll love that too.
One for Raglan Road. We've been to Raglan Road before, but this will be our first time at the Edison. Mm-hmm. We also have a reservation for the Jungle Skipper's Canteen.
Oh, you're going to love that too.
And otherwise, we're hoping to get over to, we want to get to like Jock Lindsay's. We want to check out yes. Tutto Gusto Lounge in the Italy Pavilion at Epcot. And Monica says there's a place called Gideon's Bakehouse that.
Yes, that's on my list too.
Yeah. And the Everglazed Donuts. That's the other place that looks amazing.
Gideon's opened the day we were leaving, and I saw it on Facebook that it opened. And so my husband was like, okay, I'm going to run in and get you a cookie real quick and you can take it to the airport. Yeah. And I'm like, I'm too tired. I don't want to sit in the car, blah, blah, blah. And then later I saw it was like a 75 hour wait. And I'm all, here we are thinking you're going to run in and get me a cookie. So funny. He was like, wait, what? A 14 hour wait for a cookie? I'm like, yeah, but they look really good.
I have to say, Justin, I'm very impressed with your choices.
Me too. Every
one of our ones that I haven't tried and I want to try it too. That was great. And of course, you're going to have to get a Ronto wrap and you're going to have to get some tip yip.
When we're there, I mean, we'll do some of that kind of stuff. We do have a reservation at Olga's Cantina as well for the one day. Mm-hmm. I think that's the Tuesday that we're there. And otherwise, you know, we'll get some fish and chips in Epcot and
sure.
Now what I'm also really looking forward to is the Flower and Garden Festival starts on the 3rd, and I'm going to be at Epcot on the 4th, so I'm, you know, anxious to try some of the food booths that they have available. So that's kind of going to be like the early day snacking stuff, and then dinner later.
You're gonna have to take pictures of all anything you do sample, post it on our magical ticket page or holders page.
So Justin, for Topolino's, I think it used to be buffet. Does that sound right? Did it used to be buffet?
I think it was buffet. I think it was
okay. So when we ordered, it was like a quiche. You just get like one quiche and it's like, how much is it? $42 or something for breakfast. And my husband was like, gosh, this is kind of a pricey breakfast. And
I don't like quiche at all, to tell you the truth.
Oh, it was delicious. So the quiche was really, really good. But they let you have whatever else you want too. So you get the quiche and you can ask for a side of bacon, a side of ham, a side of potatoes, toast, whatever you want. So they don't say that on the menu, but when you're ordering, if you wanted bacon on the side, it's all included, but they don't really openly announce that. So just a little tip for you. So, cause I know we really wanted the quiche, but my husband's like, really, quiche for 42? That's all I'm getting is a little quiche. But no, he ended up getting eggs. They'll give you as many eggs as you want and bacon. And prime rib, please. So we actually, and they start you out with that little,
whatever you want.
Bread basket. So we actually, and then,
I understand there's a bucket of pastries involved.
Yes. And they're so good.
Oh, they are. And they're delicious.
And then the juice, I think it's the Pong juice, and then coffee is also included. So they don't say this on the menu. So we learned it. Luckily, we had a really good server that kind of let us in on that. But so
how can they not advertise that? Like,
I don't know. Because
I could see people going there and going, wow, that was a ripoff. I had a glass of water and quiche, and it was $42.
Yeah, exactly. So my aunt, when I invited her, she was like, yeah, I'll go. But she was hesitant too, because of the price and because of it was only like five menu items, like a waffle, a quiche, bacon and eggs or whatever. And then when our server was like, oh, did you want eggs with that? And she's like, oh, well, how much is that? He's like, no, whatever you want, eggs, you guys want a side of bacon. And so we were actually really happy and the service was really good. The food was outstanding. The views, I would really like to go back here with my family, but I can't do both. It's either Be Our Guest or Topolino's. We can't do it. So
actually the characters, you know, even though they don't come directly to your table, they did come around close enough numerous times.
Yeah.
So you could get some really good pictures. So, I mean,
I don't know if you can do
selfies or what, you know, just take pictures of them, but yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah. I actually really enjoy the new way of dining, character dining, because the old way, they come to your table and I mean, they really, interrupt you, and focused on, oh my gosh, they're coming, okay, move over, stand up, and this way you kind of still enjoy your food, and then they do a little dance over to the side, and then they come up behind you and they'll take a selfie, and it's more, I don't know, that I, for me, the experience, it seems so much better. And maybe it'll be different with the kids because they can't hug them, and I'm sure that's probably a big issue. But they still make sure that they get in the back of your photo. They still make sure they're waving to you and entertaining you. And I don't know. So for me, it seemed better. It wasn't, like I said, the characters interrupting.
It wasn't as frantic. Well,
yeah. Uh-huh. And not only that, when you used to have the old buffet style dining, you'd be up getting your bacon and Winnie the Pooh's at your table, and you're pushing small children out of the way to get to them.
Yeah.
Get a picture while he's at your table.
Right. That's what I'm saying. So you're trying to eat, you're trying to hurry and get your food, and like, you frantic. I think that's a perfect explanation. So I don't know. I'm really enjoying the new character dining, how they're bringing it, the buffet. I mean, the food to me is so much better. And I would assume it's a lot less waste too than the buffets as well. Oh, yeah. So. Yeah.
Kris, do you know if they have the characters back at Crystal Palace?
I don't know. Okay. But, you know, they have Cinderella's at Cinderella's Royal Table. The other princesses are not there, but she was coming out several times during my meal time, just like at Be Our Guest, Beast comes through. It's a lot quicker with him going from room to room, where Cinderella just kind of comes out and she's on this like little balcony area and she's interacting and waving and talking, and and that was great. I really enjoyed that. So I'll be anxious to see what happens at Crystal Palace as well.
Let's talk some snacks. Let's start with Justin this time. Justin, what snacks are you looking to gobble up, or do you not have plans quite yet?
Well, obviously we have to get a Dole Whip. We're going to get to Gideon's Bakehouse for some stuff there if we can. And otherwise, you know, the usual kind of ice cream and whatnot, whatever we feel like having when we feel like having it.
Yeah, because you like to just play it by ear when it comes to stuff like that.
We really
Anything
do.
At Festival of the Arts that you particularly want to try?
You know, I haven't really even looked into much of what's there. We're going to be kind of running through pretty quickly, I think. So
Okay. You know, we did a whole show on the live show about it. I believe you were.
I know. I'm like, wait a second.
That was a food thing.
Do Kris, you like coconut, Justin?
Oh, absolutely.
You need to get that coconut Dole Whip.
Okay.
Yeah.
It was really good.
And where is that located?
At Aloha Isle.
Oh, okay.
And what the heck is it called? Coca? Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I can't think of it off the top of my head. But
well, anyways, it's advertised there. Once you just look throw at the cake pop away because it's disgusting, and then just eat the Dole Whip. But it's really good, really, really good.
Well, also there's the Peter Pan flight. I'm guessing Justin never tried. And Holly, you finally were able to hunt one down after your
I did. Yeah,
Magic Kingdom.
That was good. Better for a hot day though.
And that's in that restaurant in Fantasyland.
Yes.
It's like a Dole Whip, but it's lime instead of pineapple.
Yeah, lime and then Sprite, a float of Sprite.
Yeah, and has a red feather, chocolate feather. Yeah. Feather from off chicken, from a rooster. No, it has a chocolate feather in it as well. Kris, how about you? You must have a bunch of snacks, being the food fairy.
Well, I have to get a citrus swirl because that's our jam, right, Stan? Gotta go get a citrus swirl the day that I go to Magic Kingdom the first time, and I'll probably get another one the day that I am there the last time as well. But I don't know, I'm just gonna kind of play snacking by ear. You know, if I see something that I want to try, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna get it. But I don't have a snack plan as of right now. I'm still kind of working on stuff like that, but we'll see.
Check out what was at the Flower and Garden last year and kind of get an idea of what type of things will be there.
Yeah, I think I want to say that possibly Disney Food Blog has the items up already for Flower and Garden. Maybe, you know, of course, no pictures and stuff as of right now, but I think they have the list. So I'm going to check that out and make some plans and see what happens.
Cool. Now, Holly, you said you have a snack attack list, and I'm assuming that the spring rolls, the cheeseburger spring rolls, are going to be on that.
It's list. On there, but I'm not going to. Well, I'm thinking, no, I will be there Thursday this time. And I think the spring roll cart is open Thursday through Sunday. So I might get lucky and get a cheeseburger spring roll this time. But once again, just like the people mover, I'm not going to hold my breath this time. But I did see that they are serving the Nutella waffle again. So that will be on my list. And then I have to get carrot cake cookie again, because that was so amazing. And the Wookiee cookie, I really need to try that. So
at Backlot Express
in So those are on my list. And then I think I'm going to get that coconut Dole Whip again. And my daughter loves the Mickey pretzels. So we'll probably have a few of those. And yeah, so we'll probably have more snacks this time actually than last time because of the kids.
With the Nutella waffle, I prefer it with whipped cream on it.
Okay.
You have to ask for it. And sometimes they grumble. I have people that are like, oh, absolutely. And he's just topped up with the whipping cream beautifully. And I had other people going, what? You want to change the recipe? Are you crazy? Like, they kind of like made me feel bad that I asked. But
no, I'm not crazy.
But my pro tip is to get the whipping cream on the Nutella.
Okay. Got it.
Well, that's like asking for extra icing on the cinnamon roll at Gaston's.
Yeah, which I could see that beneficial, because the outer ring of the cinnamon roll is a little bit on the drier side, but I might have to get another one of those too.
Yeah.
Well, I want you guys to have a lot of fun on your trip. We're going to pull back into the dock or the spaceport or wherever the heck we're on today.
Not the people mover.
Green station.
The loading dock. Guys, all right, everybody, out of the bus.
Out of the bus.
Honestly, you guys, I want to wish you guys to have a beautiful trip, a wonderful time, a magical time, as they say. Any final thoughts, Stan, before we sign off?
I'm just hoping it's warm, because I'm freezing right now. Blizzard conditions here, and I'm looking forward to at least 70-something.
I think you'll get that.
Yeah,
because it's been about 80 there.
Yeah,
I've been watching the weather.
I need to thaw. Flower
and Garden is very nice. It's a very nice time to go. And Holly, have you ever gone during Flower and Garden?
I have. It's beautiful. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The smell is what I remember the most.
Yeah.
Years since I've been. But the smell is amazing. All righty, Ken, take it away.
If you would like to keep the adventure going after the show, be sure to like our Facebook friends page, Grand Circle Tours Magical Ticket Holders. While you're on Facebook, like our group page, Grand Circle Tours. Be sure to follow us on Twitter, Grand Circle Tours Podcast, as well as on Instagram, GCT Podcast, and our YouTube channel, Grand Circle Tour. If you would like to email us, drop us a line at gctpodcast@gmail.com. T-shirts and other fun merchandise can be found at tpublic.com. Simply search Grand Circle Tour Podcast. If you enjoyed your adventure, leave us a review on Apple Podcast. Only one rule, make it good. All logos, sounds, songs, and music that are made by and for Disney and its affiliates are the full ownership of the Disney Corporation and are not, nor are they intended to be, the ownership of the Grand Circle Tour Podcast. Thank you for riding with us, and welcome home.
Well, what do you think? We have time to go to the bathroom before the next show?
We can't, you old fool. We're bolted to the seats.